signs that you are saved, signs that you have become a Christian. Number one, peace
Udo
and joy.
Ogo.
What did I call it?
Peace
and what?
Udo.
And joy.
Ogo.
There is this joy that follow us when you first met him. There is this peace that flood your heart. John 14 and verse 27. John chapter 14 and verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you.
Right.
Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be what? Afraid. Peace!
Udo.
In the midst of crisis, in the midst of want, you have eternal peace. There is this assurance. There is this peace that engulf your spirit. There is this peace that flood your heart. Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. Philippians chapter 4 verse 7. And the peace of God which passeth all understanding shall keep your heart and mind through Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
The peace that passeth what? All human, that is this peace. The first time you give your life to Christ, there is this peace. Even though there is sickness, even though there is threats of your life, you still have this peace. Colossians chapter 3 verse 15. Colossians chapter 3 verse 15. Colossians 3 15. And let the peace of God rule your heart, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the peace rule your heart. The peace comes to your heart. The gospel moves with the peace of God. And in John chapter 15, verse 11. John 15, 11. He said, these things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. That is joy unspeakable. Full of grace. You are joyful. That's why you can boast in songs and tongues and glorify God. The Bible said that when they flogged them, after beating them, in Acts chapter 4, in Acts chapter 5, the Bible said they went home rejoicing. They went home what? Rejoicing. Somebody flogged you. Somebody beat you up. Somebody dealt with you because you preached Jesus Christ. Instead of you to be angry, the Bible said they went home what? Rejoicing. Because the joy that has taken over them is not the joy of men. It is the joy that accompanying the personality of
Christ
that is in you. And the Bible said, count it all joy when men persecute you. Count it all joy. But these days, you see a little tribulation here. You see a light affliction there. Somebody is already complaining. Somebody is already discouraged. You have not encountered the word. Because when you encounter the word, the Bible says we speak to ourselves with psalms, hymns and spiritual songs to build our spirit and stand firm in the time of challenges. The sign that you are safe. Number two, you will love the word of God and it will abide with you. You will love it. You will love it. It's a sign that you are saved. Deep, call it deep. It is only a man with water on the inside that will understand the call of the sea. If you have not encountered him, you will not enjoy his word. John chapter 15 verse 7. Are you sure you are still here? If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask anything and it shall be done unto you. If you abide in me, the next thing that follows is my word will abide in you. Do you have the abidance of the word of God? When was the last time you studied the Bible? Have you read through the scripture from Genesis to Revelation? How many times? Not just read it once. How many times? If we carry your Bible now, can we have a mark in that Bible? Have you actually used the Bible? Or is it for decoration? John chapter 8, verse 43 to 47. The Bible says something important. It says, why do you not understand my speech? Even because you cannot hear my word. Ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Now, pause it there. Let me come. Do you know the interpretation of that place? If the devil speaks, he speaks lie. It is his nature. It is his what? His nature. If the devil said the truth, people will be surprised. He can't say the truth. Because even when he wants to say the truth, he will end up lying. Because that is his nature. And Jesus was talking to the people. He said, you are like your father now. Your father is a murderer. He doesn't listen to the truth. So anyone who reacts against the truth has a father. And his name is the devil. Three signs that this one is saved is he will walk and be full of love. There is no genuine Christian who does not walk in love. Christianity is love personified. That's why when I look at some of you, you frown your face. That's how to know those who don't have Jesus in the church. Just look church. Around. Their face is just like this. They are not interested in anything we are doing. Their mind is in Abuja. They don't care about what is going on. They are waiting for the time of signs and wonders. Frown. Anyone you see that frown in the church, ask the person, who is your father? Are you a child of God? Are you a Christian? Do you have love? It's a commandment. Love is the reason why people jam churches. You don't preach to condemn. You correct by love. You don't correct by embarrassing somebody. You correct with love. I wrote some things here. I say love is the nature of God. According to 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 to 8, the Bible says, he that love is of God, for God is love. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, if you read from verse 1, the Bible says, if you have gifts, if you have wonders and miracles, if you lack love, you are like an empty drum that make the loudest noise. Love is the weight of a Christian. Is the value of a Christian. There is no pretense in love. Love strengthens and directs. Love endures. No marriage can stand outside love. No relationship can last outside love. Our journey with Christ is the journey of love. Without love, you are not a Christian. Number four.
Okay, no.
You must possess a manifest the fruit of the Spirit. That's a sign that you are saved. According to Galatians chapter 5, 22 to 24,
you
see, the fruit of the Spirit is a clear sign that Christ has been fully welcomed into your heart. If you don't have Him, you can't produce after His order. It is called the fruit, not the seed, not the tree. Meaning that the seed is what produces the fruit. It is the seed, and the seed is the word of God, and the word of God is Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ,
according to Mark chapter 4 verse 14, and the sower sow the word. Luke chapter 8 and verse 11, and the seed is the word. Revelation chapter 19 and verse 13, and the name written on him is the word of God. Let the seed of God's word germinate the character of the Holy Ghost. Let's read that, and then we move into prayer. Galatians chapter 5, 22 to 24. But the fruit of the Spirit is, can we be naming it? One is what? Shout it. Number two is what? Number three is what? Number four is what? Number five is what? Number six is what? Seven is what? Eight is meekness. Nine is what? Temperance. The Bible said, against such, there is no law. Against such, there is no law. So ask your neighbor, do you have these qualities? When you go home, I'm giving it to you as an assignment. Read the fruit again. If you don't have it, come and answer out our call. Whether I am in the church or not. And ask God to have mercy. Child of God, it is expected of you and I to manifest Christ. If you lose heaven, you can't miss hell. There is no two ways about that. If you don't end in heaven, you must definitely end in hell. And that is not the mind of Christ. His desire is that we live for Him. If we possess these qualities, what moved the world will not move us. We are not going to be tensed up. We are not going to be troubled side to side. Because the word of God richly dwells in us. Jeremiah 16 said, I find your word. I eat it. And it became the joy and the rejoicing of my soul. Be ruled by the word of God. Become a Christian. Let the light reflect. Let people look at you and say, a Christian. In conclusion, until there is a past in your life. When I talk about past, I'm talking about past character. I used to do this before. No, I don't do it again. Until there is that, you are not yet saved.